Hey everybody, we're here at the CSF building where we'd normally be on a Thursday night, and I just want to give you all a quick update on where we stand with things. The same week that CSF was being asked by the university to shut down all our activities, the CDC released a study, and that study had some disturbing findings. And the findings were that in the past 30 days, just in the past month, just over one quarter of all college-age Americans had considered suicide. So many more had struggled with depression and loneliness and the like. And I mentioned that study because we know that when people are isolated and people are put through immense times of stress, that their mental, emotional, even their spiritual health, physical health can all tend to start to go downhill. And that was the heart behind where we're at. And let me just say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for where we're at. I wish we weren't at this crossroads. But I want to explain to you kind of how we got here. You know, our intent for kickoff week was that we would host events that were, you know, socially distanced, that people would wear masks. We put up all kinds of hand sanitizer stations. We had all kinds of signage printed up. We wanted to host fun, safe events. That was our intent. You know, but there were a couple of instances over the K-week, kickoff week time frame that happened, one of which was a S'more of Summer event. You may have seen some footage online. Some of that footage isn't even CSF, but that's okay. Certainly, our event had a lot of students there. And the difficulty was is that it was, and the university said, you didn't keep people appropriately spaced out enough. Certainly, we gave our best efforts. We went around asking people, hey, can you spread out? We put up signs. We did all of those things. But one of the difficulties was is that there were only three events the first Friday night of school with thousands of students on campus, only three events that the university advertised and told students about. Ours was one of them. And it just became difficult to control students. I've talked to the organizers of the other two events. They said we had the exact same problems at our events. We didn't know there were only three options for students on campus that night, and so the demand was just so tough. We were actually even handing out $5 gift cards at the gate saying, you can't come in. We're so sorry. We want CSF to be a welcoming place. Here's a $5 gift card to go away. Obviously not what we want to do, but we were trying to do our best to have these safe events. You know, we've struggled. We've struggled with hearing some things the university said to us. They've compared our events to hazing events, saying that, you know, we're putting students' health in jeopardy in the same way a fraternity might do so with fraternity hazing. To be clear, we told the university about our events. We gave them a full list, a full description of everything we were going to be doing, of where people would be seated, of all those different things. We tried to be a good partner. But as we stand right now, the university has said synergy cannot take place, your worship gathering cannot take place, your shift can't take place, small group Bible studies can't take place. It is a really difficult position they put us in. And what they're asking of CSF is that we would essentially plead guilty. This isn't criminal charges like with the Lexington police, but we would plead guilty as an organization to COVID violations to say that you all didn't do what you're supposed to do with COVID. And what we've maintained is that we did the best that we could. We had a plan. We asked students to do this, just like their own university's own events. Those have not been perfect. Students have not been perfectly socially distanced at all times, but we tried our best to execute a plan. The difficulty we find ourselves in is that the university, if they were to shut down due to COVID, and that may well happen, as I'm sure you all are aware, that the university could lose tens of millions of dollars. And when the university said, hey, you know what, we'll let you reopen CSF, potentially let you even reopen in the next few days, if you plead guilty to these charges. We spoke with several attorneys. Our board unanimously said, we cannot plead guilty to these charges. One, we feel like we tried to execute events that were safe and healthy for students and also fun, allowing students to come together, allowing you all to build friendships, to invite other people into the great community of CSF because it's so needed at this point. But if we were to plead guilty and admit to guilt and say, yes, we did these things, it would put us on the hook with a liability issue that if the university lost millions of dollars and they said, you know what, we're going to actually come after CSF and potentially sue CSF. We're asking the UK legal team currently to give us assurances that, you know, that we won't be sued. Thus far, we haven't heard anything back on that. We certainly hope that they would give us something like that. But we cannot plead guilty to charges knowing that then they could take us to court and sue us and saying, you all admitted that you violated COVID regulations. And that is not an admission that we are willing to make in the legal process with UK. But let me stress this in a pivotal turn, is that Romans 8:28 is that great passage. where God says so clearly, where he says all things, not just fun things, nice things, you know, warm, good, feely things, all things, even tough things, hard things, bad things, things that don't look on the surface like they're good. All things work together for the good for those who love God and are called according to his purpose. And so we are trusting that God is going to use us. I just have a trust. Am I frustrated? Yes. Do I feel like that CSF is being treated in a harsher manner than even the way the university is assessing its own performance? I do feel that way. But we are trusting that God is going to use this. He is going to use this for good. And so there was a prayer that I have prayed recently, and I wanted to share it with you all even this morning. Maybe it's a prayer for you all as you all feel frustrated, because as I have felt frustrated. And it's a prayer out of this book. Some of you may have seen it before. It's called Every Moment Holy. And it's all these random prayers for all these random moments in life. And one of the moments was, it's a prayer for having an irritation in your life. And this is what the prayer says. And I hope even as I pray it, you find yourself praying this. It says, Lord, I bring to you my momentary irritations, that you might reveal the buried seed of it, not in the words or actions of another person that's irritated me, but in the withered and hypocritical expectations of my own small heart. Uproot from my impoverished soul all arrogance and insecurity that would prompt me to dismiss or to disdain and dislike others, judging them with a less generous measure than I reckon when judging myself. Lord, please prune away the tangled growth of my own unjustified irritations. Please, Jesus, graft into my heart instead your humility, your compassion, your patience, your kindness, that I might bear fruit in keeping with your grace. Amen. You know, the university, as much as I've been frustrated with this process, I do want to say the university is trying to keep this place open and going, and I have deep sympathies for that. The university and education for centuries upon centuries, well before, you know, America was even a place, has involved students paying teachers for money. That just is part of what teachers need to earn a living, and they need to be paid to do that. And so I understand the business aspects of the university, and they're just trying to keep the university open in a way that allows them to continue to pay workers, because there are so many people here, from custodians to cafeteria workers to administrative assistants to professors, who this is their livelihood. They need this to pay for kids' school clothes, for housing bills, for meals. And so I do want us to have, and I do have sympathy with the university for what they're trying to do. They're trying to do their job. I want to let you know, we'll work through this. We are. We're working through this with the university. We have a hearing. I hope it's next week with the university, which should allow us to reopen. There's still even some hope that next week we'll have Synergy. When we do have it, we're going to move to Southland's Richmond Road campus. That'll give us tons of space to be out in the open and where we can socially distance appropriately together. And so I have hope. I do have hope. And I want to share a small piece of hope with you. I have this great mother-in-law. If she's watching this, yes, Deb, I said you're great. And she is a great mother-in-law. And she texted me this passage, and I thought it was absolutely beautiful. And I want to share it with you all as we wind this time down. And it's simply this. It's from Isaiah 51:10. It's about 10 or so verses long, not about 7 verses long. But let me just read these verses to you. Starting in verse 10, Isaiah 51:10. Was it not you, Lord, who dried up the sea, the waters of the great deep, who made a road in the depths of the sea, so that the redeemed might cross over? The ransomed of the Lord will return. They will enter Zion with singing. Everlasting joy will crown their heads. Gladness and joy will overtake them, and sorrow and sighing and all that COVID has brought us will flee away. I, the Lord, even I'm the one who comforts you. Who are you that you fear mere mortal men and what they can do to you? The sons of men who are but grass, that you would forget the Lord your Maker in this time, the one who stretched out the heavens and laid the foundations of the earth, that you who live in constant terror every day of the things around you, because of the wrath of the oppressor who is bent on destruction. For where is the wrath of the oppressor? Hear this, the cowering prisoners will soon be set free. They will not die in their dungeon, nor will they lack for bread. For I am the Lord your God, who churns up the sea so that its waves roar. The Lord Almighty is his name. I have put my words in your mouth and covered you with the shadow of my own hand. I who set the heavens in place, who laid the foundations of the earth, and who say to Zion, and who says to you, CSF, you are my people. And so I want us to have hope. I want you to know that God is working. We are working here. Yes, our programs have been shut down for a short period of time, and we hope to have those open very soon. But I want you to hear in that hope that there is hope, in that passage that there's hope, that the Lord is at work. He was there yesterday. Even in that passage you hear, if you know that story of the Exodus, when they left Egypt, that God separated the waters. Even though the Egyptian army was trailing them, God made a way. God was faithful with them in the past. Isaiah is saying he's going to be with you here. And we see that in the future, God was with them in the person of Jesus. He's with us in the person of Jesus. God has not forgot us. He has not forgotten you personally. In the meantime, what can you do? Well, you can grab lunch. We'd love to grab lunch. In fact, as soon as this is over, I'm going to grab a meal with a freshman just to connect. So if you've got a staff member you'd love to have lunch with, send them a text. Your core group leader, send them a text. We've had some amazing donors offer to say, just take all the students you want out to Chipotle, to Bourbon and Toulouse, to a local taco. We'll pay for it. Amazing generosity of people that if we can just pray together and be together and share together in whatever ways, you can do that. If you don't know who to text, you go, I don't know who to reach out to. There's a link in the description of this video, and you can just click on that and go, hey, it'll send a form into the staff, and we'd love to grab a lunch with you. If you want to be a part of a small group, you go, hey, well, I'm not a part of a small group yet. When those start up in the next week or two, how do I get in one? Just go to ukcsf.org, and there's a link there to show you, how to sign up for one of those. And we'd love to have you in a group to find that community during this time. If you want one of these cool t-shirts, I'm told, as an announcement tonight, we'll be starting to sell those soon. You can go to our Instagram, just UKCSF. Follow us on Instagram, Twitter. You can find out how to get one of these. In fact, I think tonight even, we're giving away 3 free t-shirts of the designs, this being one of them. But hop on our Instagram right now. If you don't follow us. This is a great way to stay on top of the news. Lastly, I want to close with this. Normally, on a Thursday night, we're here in this room, we're here in this building, and we sing. And we just open up our hearts to God, and we go, God, man, I come in here with all kinds of things, anxiety over tests, loneliness, whatever it is we bring into these places. Sometimes great things, sometimes hard things. But worship is this beautiful time where we just lay our hearts and our minds out before God, and we say, God, I just want to meet you. And so even though tonight we're not here singing, I want to do something unique. I want us to actually worship together in a unique way by listening and watching something. And both the words and the images, I think, are very important for this time. And those words and images, they're from a student at CSF, Matt Zola, who actually recently graduated. It's a song that he wrote and he recorded. It just says, be still, my soul. Just be still during these anxious times with CSF being so uncertain right now for the next week or so. Be still, my soul, during COVID, during Zoom classes, during all these other things. Just be still. And the images are actually from a video we put together of the last full year we had together before COVID. It's images of just the things that were going on that year of a couple school years back where we said, man, I think it was the 2018-19 school year. And what I want you to see in those images is that God, in the same way we mentioned that Isaiah 51 passage, God was faithful. He was faithful in the past. That when he's been faithful then, he'll be faithful now, he'll be faithful in the future. And so as we close tonight, I just want you all to worship together. As we listen to this song, if you happen to know it, we've sung it a few times at CSF, feel free to sing along. But may it be a worship song for you tonight, as you listen to those words, as you see those images, that we celebrate God's faithfulness to us. So until we see each other face to face, grace, peace, see you soon.
Revealed in your light. Be still.